Why do my plants wear socks? Not only do my plants enjoy being super fashionable, but this blocks light from reaching the medium and creating algae growth. It keeps it super clean.
You were a phonograph, I was a kid, I sat with an...
The day finally came for me to propagate my philodendron glorious. I put these three cuttings into a glass vessel so that I can water propagate. This is all that was left of the mother plant, and I'm just going to leave it as it is. All I'm using is plain tap water and setting it in a bright location until I see roots appear. Once they do, I'm going to pot everything back together with a moss pole. Air layering provides extra insurance for when we propagate a plant. So you can just take a cutting and root the cutting, which is what I do most of the time. However, by air layering, you're pre-preparing and like pre-growing the roots for the plant for when you do that chop. So this plant is going to have a much better shot at survival and growing. And another big reason that I'm doing it is because I want to try to maintain as much maturity as possible. I am finally getting some more mature leaves on this thing, and it is just so beautiful. So I just want to give it the best chance possible. So yeah, still in there, rooting up pretty well. You can see there's more roots in there. Oh, and also, I did end up adding the second vine into there as well through the plastic. I cut a little hole, so that vine is rooting into there as well. Thanks for your question. So my philodendron varicosum that I've been air layering has rooted way more than I even expected. Like, there's so many roots, and it's like right fastened into the moss pole, so I think I'm gonna have to cut it. The moss pole is decapitated. Feel like I am doing surgery here. That was quite the procedure to get that off, but this is the result of the air layering. I now have like a fully rooted plant. Look at that. That is craziness. And I also have a little itty bitty secondary cutting from the other vine. This is the finished result. Looks pretty good. It's gonna look even better once we get some more leaves up here, cover up my ugly zip ties. But yeah. That's how he's looking.
No, seriously, what is this place?
This is heaven.
Hello, happy Thursday. I just wanted to show you my beautiful philodendron painted lady because she's incredible. And I just moved her out of the cabinet a few weeks ago and she's doing amazing, so good for her. That's all, bye.
Crazy. I'm crazy for feeling.
You're crazy, girl.
You know what? I could. I really could. But see, the problem is, I don't want to.
I'm Mr. White Christmas. I'm high on crack.
I've never met anyone else like you. And I don't think I ever will. I'm not saying that because it's cliche. I'm saying that because no one's ever moved me the way that you do.
Just so you know, Mom, I am about to do something that's very, very big, very important. When you hear about...
It's called self-care. Look it up.
When I say I'm up to no good, I don't mean I'm out cheating or doing drugs or drinking. If I'm up to no good, I'm buying fucking plants.
Hey y'all, this is my setup video for my houseplant fertilizer experiment. I picked up this Hartley philodendron from Callaway's. They didn't have any 4-inch pots, so I went ahead and I got this massive one just to break up into 4 equal pots for the sake of this experiment. So here I am tearing that root ball apart super, super gently. Got some dechlorinated water on there. And we're gonna give these guys a little pest bath. So we're doing a dose of neem oil as well as a little bit of hydrogen peroxide just to make sure that everything is nice and sanitary and clean. And then I went ahead and I separated them into 4 different piles, trying to keep them as equal as possible. Here are our little piles, super cute. And my pots. And then I went ahead and I tossed them in there. And while I'm finishing up potting this up, I can talk a little bit about why I wanted to do this experiment. I've just heard so many different things about different fertilizers that can be used for houseplants. Everything from the natural gardening side of things to houseplant influencers talking about their favorite fertilizers. So I want to find mine. I mostly collect philodendrons, so that's why I chose this more hardy plant just to give it a test on. It's also not super expensive, which is great. All of these experiment plants were potted with Fox Farm Ocean Forest soil. I just went straight out of the bag there. That's normally what I do. This is where they're gonna be permanently living on my plant shelf, so they're all getting the same amount of light. I also made some labels to make sure that I'm keeping them separate and that we're not gonna get any of them crisscrossed while I'm watering them. Also, peep my favorite snack in the entire world in the background, frozen blueberries. If you've never had them, please try them. So for the 4 categories, we have a control, which is just going to be dechlorinated water, the houseplant fertilizer, which is a natural fertilizer from Amazon, compost tea, and my vegan fertilizer that I'm kind of crafting up on my own. I'm excited to see where this takes us.
I take the ball, I bounce it, I shoot, I miss it.
Hey y'all, happy Earth Day. Today I'm going to be showing y'all how I use my food scraps for my vermicomposting. My worm bin makes some beautiful homemade earthworm castings that I use to add nutrients to my plants. Since I live in an apartment, this helps reduce my food waste before these little scraps go to our compost pile. These worms love to eat anything that's traditionally tossed into a compost bin. The only things you're going to want to avoid are citrus altogether, meat and dairy, none of that in there as well, and then light amounts of eggshells. They don't eat that as much, but they love anything that's soft tissued like these green beans, lettuce, bell peppers, cucumbers, fruit, all of it. They love it so much. I always give it a nice stir and make sure to cover up all the food scraps to avoid any pests. You can see this bell pepper stem they've been chewing on. It's so interesting to see how they work through these scraps. About once a month, I have to add a little bit of water just to keep it a little bit damp in there, but otherwise, that's it. That's vermicomposting.
My money don't jiggle, jiggle. It folds. I like to see you wiggle, wiggle. For sure, it makes me want to dribble, dribble. You know.
You can do it too, believe it. I've been a blow up the sex in a...
Here's a challenge. Can you do it without flexing? What's your favorite common houseplant in your collection?
My philodendron fuzzy petiole. They are sold at Kroger now, so they are common, haha.
Wait.
This is my first IKEA greenhouse cabinet. It's gonna be the Millsbow Wide. IKEA has been out of stock of these guys forever. I bought it 2 years ago. I have it modified with some corner acrylic shelves, some upcycled computer fans, as well as my grow light with some diffusion fabric on it. This cabinet is still in the middle of a remodel, so we're kind of just chilling with it. My greenhouse cabinet just helps me maintain a more consistent humidity. Since my plant room does fluctuate between 50 to 70% humidity, my cabinet will always be at 80% humidity for these more sensitive plants, like my varicosum, my Monstera albo, calatheas, honestly anything that I care about getting any crispy edges. This maintained humidity just makes sure that they're going to stay nice and happy and keep on growing. Here's who is living in my IKEA greenhouse cabinet right now. First is my philodendron Florida ghost, and then we have some philodendron pink princess cuttings, a philodendron white princess, the stratoscantia, as well as some philodendron Shangri-La and red emerald cuttings that I'm propagating. Down on the bottom, I have my philodendron painted lady, my philodendron viricosum, my philodendron splendid, and then of course my monstera albo, just so she can get all of that beautiful light. My philodendron squammy, we have a calathea orbifolia, and then a philodendron ring of fire, my other pink princess, and then my philodendron strawberry shake. A lot of these guys will be moving to my new cabinet when I set it all up.